Hello guys, Steven here, back with another video. Today I'll be teaching you how to make YouTube thumbnails. I feel like I say that so many times. I have like so many videos about thumbnails, but they're very important, very essential. It's the first thing people see on your channel, basically, when they look at your videos, right? So I'm gonna teach you how to make them. I'm gonna talk about like some techniques and strategies I use and some tips and tricks for you guys. But I feel like I make a video like this every 4 months, so I'm trying to go really in depth so you guys can so this is like future proof and you can use this whenever, because my other tutorials, I've changed them up and stuff, but I think I'm gonna stick with this type of style. But obviously I'll still be improving and my thumbnails are gonna continue to improve as I go on. But this is basically everything you need to know about how to make a thumbnail. I think this tutorial will really help you guys out. And yeah, I'll link everything you need in the description, and let's just get into the video. The first thing you wanna do is go on to File, New. And before I get started, I just want to say, if I'm going too fast at any point in the video, you can pause the video. I see a lot of comments saying I go too fast and you can't follow along. You can pause the video. The reason I go pretty fast is because I don't want the video to be too long. Usually I don't want a video to be longer than 10 minutes. So the first thing you want to do is type in 920 by 1080. So let me just type it right this time. Make sure the unit is pixels and the background contents is transparent, as well as RGB color mode. Once you're done that, press OK. So this is your canvas for your thumbnail. The first thing I do is open up a graphics pack. There are many out there, but I'm gonna go here, graphics, and I'm gonna graphics pack. And the one I use is Temper's 4K graphics pack. I used to use this one by Visual, but I use Temper's now. I'll link both in the description for you guys. Basically what a graphics pack is basically a pack that you can open up on Photoshop that has a lot of stocks and backgrounds and overlays and different things that are very helpful. And the reason I love a graphics pack so much is because it's so convenient. I don't have to go on Google and spend time finding wallpapers and stuff, which was a big issue for me. Now I can just go on here and there's a bunch of things that I can choose from. So if I go into overlays, there's a bunch of overlays, there's a bunch of text stocks, there's a bunch of stocks. One wallpaper I use in particular is this one right here. I'll just drag it here. I use this because there's color, it's striped, and also looks really clean and has these like particles flying everywhere. So me personally, I like that look a lot. The next thing I'll do is determine like what my video is gonna be about. I'm gonna be making a thumbnail for, let's say, Sony Vegas Pro 14, okay? So what I'll do is go into adjustments and press hue and saturation. I'll change it to the color of Sony Vegas. So obviously Sony Vegas is blue, so I'll do that. Or it's not Sony Vegas anymore, it's Magic Vegas Pro, which is weird to say, but yeah, it is. So next thing you wanna do is press Control and click on both layers, so the hue and saturation layer, as well as the wallpaper, and press Control E to merge the layer. Now I have a blue wallpaper instead of a red one, in case you're wondering how you can change the color of the wallpaper. The next thing I do is go into Google and search up a image relevant to Sony Vegas or whatever I'm making a video on. So Sony Vegas Pro 14. And this image is not gonna be very visible. So what I mean by this is, what I'll do is just take this video. It's Sony Vegas Pro 10, but whatever, it looks the same, right? And I'm gonna go File, Place. That's how you place an image, by the way. And I'm gonna just place it here. It won't be that visible because I'm gonna lower the opacity. So it's gonna be like right there. And you'll see it, but it won't be that visible. And that way you can see the awesome stock that I have right here. So that's one thing I do. The next thing I do is add text. So here I'll say like Sony, it's not Sony anymore, I keep forgetting. So Vegas Pro 14, maybe editing guide, maybe that's good, editing guide with exclamation mark. And I'll align everything on the first letter. So what I mean by that is, see where the V starts, I'll just press space here and it'll align, so right there. Another thing I'll do is highlight the entire text, press Control T, and now I have these options. I always do italic some reason, it just looks a lot better, as well as all caps. I also change the vertical alignment just so it like tracks the text. It looks a lot cooler like that. And usually I do around 50, 60, sometimes 40. Not too much like this. So let me just set it back to like 50 maybe. And I'll press the check mark here. And now I have my text. I'll make it smaller obviously and put it in the bottom left corner as I usually do. I don't know why, maybe it's because there's color there, but it just looks a lot better when the text is small and not covering most of the thumbnail. I'm not even sure why I have text in my thumbnail, because there's a title of the video right under the thumbnail, but just keep it minimal. Make it max like 6-7 words, because if you write a lot of words, the text is going to be small and it's just going to be there. No one's going to read it. So that's very important. So the next thing I do is go into blending options. So blending options is very essential as well. So I'll right click, press blending options, and then I'll use three things. I'll use drop shadow for one. So I'm just going to show you the settings I use. So 22:22 as spread and size. I'll increase the distance a little bit to the point where the shadow is a little bit on the like right side. Like you can, you know what I mean? Like it looks a little bit 3D. Then I'll lower the opacity because I don't like the look when it's like that. I like it like that, where you can kind of see it. I'll go on a gradient overlay and I'll make the gradient like 40 or 30, and then I'll press inner glow and I'll lower it. My settings might be different than yours, so you might have to adjust it to match mine. Or you can, you know, mess around and do whatever you want. So maybe pattern overlay. I don't do that because I just don't like the look of it, but you know, it's up to you. You can also add an outer glow. I used to do that. So if you like make it white and just increase the size, you can kind of see what I mean by outer glow. But I'm done with that right now. The next thing I'll do is get a logo or something, or yes, let's just get a logo. So let's go Vegas Pro 14 logo. Images, and I can't find it for some reason. So I won't actually be adding the logo. Instead, I'll be adding like these thingies. I don't know what that's called, like the boxes or like the software boxes. And then I'll press file place once again. I'll just resize. So how you resize is press Control T, hold shift and drag to keep the aspect ratio, if you guys didn't know. And so let me just make this a little bit bigger. And once again, I'll lower the opacity and obviously put it under the text so that you can actually see the text. It looks a bit, I guess, distorted, a little bit noisy, but that's all right. Now that I'm done that, I'm going to add a little bit lighting. So lighting is very important. Most of my thumbnails in the past have just been like this. It's plain. But if you add lighting, it really changes the mood of the thumbnail. So one thing I'll do is go into my brush here, make a new layer. So this right here, this notepad thing next to the garbage can. And here under the settings, you want to make the hardness 0. And you want to make the size like 2000, 3000, something really big. Make sure you're using a soft round brush. I'll zoom out, so hold Alt and scroll, or you can just use this, right? You want to press on the brush, and as you can see, half the brush is on the screen, half of it is off the screen, like off the thumbnail. And that's what you want. You don't want the entire brush on the thumbnail, or else it'll be like this, right, when you press it. I want half of it, or like a like one third of it. And then here, you can see lighting. So tell me, does this look better than this? Because me personally, I'd choose the one with the lighting. The next thing I'll do is add a little bit of color, so I'll also add blue to it as well. So let me make another layer and increase it like that. If it's a little bit too colorful, you can lower the opacity, obviously. Next thing I'll do is maybe add an overlay if I don't like the look of it right now, because I really don't like the look of it right now. Maybe the overlay will make it look a little bit better. Let me just move it under here and press soft light, or maybe linear dodge. I usually do linear dodge, and this looks pretty good to me. But it's a little bit too bright, so I'll go on hue and saturation and lower the lightness here. And now that looks a little bit better. And right now I just want to add a little bit more color to it, like more brightness to it. So I'm going to add the lighting again because it's a little bit too dark. There. And this thing's at the bottom and you can't really see it anymore. So let's just put it up here and make it linear dodge and move it down under the text and lower the opacity so you can kind of see the other stuff as well. And to finalize, I usually add halftones, and halftones are just like little dots and they give a cool effect and stuff. Usually if I don't have a logo and I just have text, I'll make the text a lot bigger, so I'll do that. Most times I'll have a logo or some like person in the thumbnail or something like that, but in this case I can't find the logo for it, so I'll actually make the text a little bit bigger and make it in the middle. Otherwise I'll keep the text in a corner. But here, let's just move it up here. And then I want to center it. So I want to press Control A. You can either go on layer, align layers to selection, and press vertical centers and horizontal centers. Or you can do this and you can press the text layer, press Control A, the move tool, and you can select this option and this option. Just to finalize it one more time, I go on to brightness and contrast, and I go like for the first five options here, I'd use it, and hue and saturation. I'll just look at how it looks like. It's really personal preference, but I usually like look at it and just like, does it look better with more contrast? And in this case, I think it does. I'll go on curves and I'll just test it out. Like, does this look better? Maybe it does.
I'll go on to exposure, and then I'll maybe change the offset a little bit so it isn't so contrasty now. So maybe like that. That looks pretty cool. Vibrance. So something like that. And now I can change the hue and saturation, see if it looks better in different colors. I gotta admit, this is not my best thumbnail, but it does show some of the techniques that I use in the process of making the thumbnail. So that should help you guys a lot. So yeah, that's basically the end of the video. If you guys did enjoy the video, hit that thumbs up button. Hopefully it did help you out, as a lot of you guys were asking for it. If we could hit 1,000 likes on this video, I know it's a lot. We hardly can hit like 300 likes. That would mean so much to me. Also, thank you for almost 40k subs. We might hit it by the time I upload this video, but thank you so much. My name is Steven, and I'll see you in the next one. Oh,